A seller marks the price 50% above the cost price and gives 10% discount on an item. While selling, he cheats the customer by giving 20% less in weight. Find his overall profit percent. Find out his overall profit percentage. Okay. Now, how do we solve this? See, understand that the question here is asking us to work on the profit percent. Now, this is the advantage we have, right? Whenever you have to deal with profit percentage or loss percentage or your value in terms of percentage, you can always assume some initial value for the cost price. Accordingly, find out the other values like the mark price, the discount, the selling price, etc. and do the calculation to arrive at the profit percentage. Because percentage doesn't really depend on the absolute value, right? If you understand the whole concept of percentage, it's actually to avoid the dependency on the absolute values. So if you can, you know, start with an assumption that the cost price is 100 and do the calculations accordingly, according to the given question, you will be getting the answer very easily, right? So I'll assume that the cost price is 100. Remember, we do not know if the cost price is 100 or not. Cost price can be taken as 110 also. Cost price can be taken as 132. Cost price can be taken as 97. You can assume any value, but it's easy to start with 100. So that is the reason. Let's take the cost price as 100. Remember, it will not impact the final answer because the final answer is in terms of percentage. So the cost price is 100. Let's assume 100 per kg. This is an assumption, right? Assumption 100 rupees per kg. The cost price is 100 rupees per kg. Yeah. The seller marks the price 50% above the cost price. So what is the mark price? I mean, I'm not going to the details of what the mark price is, what is the discount, etc. Assuming that you know the basics from our videos, the mark price will be what? Cost price plus 50% of cost price. Cost price plus 50%. It is 50% above the cost price. So you should take the mark price as 100 plus 50% of 100. So you don't have to write this step. C plus 50%, 100 plus 50%. You know that 50% more than 100 is 150. Directly you can write 150. I'm just giving you a detailed solution. So mark price is 150. And gives 10% discount. Discount is equal to 10%. 10% of what? Remember, discount is always calculated on mark price. So 10% of mark price, which is 150. What is 10% of 150? 10% of 150 is 15 rupees. Now the marked price is 150, which means he has marked the article or whatever the item is at 150 rupees per kg, but he's giving a discount of 15 rupees. So what will be the selling price? Selling price is marked price minus discount. So 150 minus 15, it comes out to be 135 rupees per kg. So we have started with an assumption that the costing is 100 rupees a kg. Calculate the mark price and discount according to the given data. And we have found that the selling price for this will be 135 rupees a kg. So if you see here, if I have to measure the profit, how much is it? 35%. What has been bought for 100 rupees is being sold for 135 rupees. Yes or no? Whatever has been bought for 100 rupees is being sold for 135 rupees. So the profit is 35%. In case the question is find the profit percentage. But here there's one more lever. What is the lever? Other lever that the person is playing here? He's while selling, he cheats the customer by giving 20% less in weight. So this way also he's making some money. You understand? So final answer is not going to be 35. Simply based on the cost price and selling price, it is 35%. But final answer will be more than 35. How do you measure that overall percentage? That is the reason he's asking us to find out overall profit percentage, right? Overall profit percentage. How do you get that? Understand, he is cheating the customer by giving 20% less in weight. Which means, assume that you are the customer and I am the shopkeeper. I am the cheater and you are the customer, right? I mean, shopkeeper, who's the cheater here? You come to me, you tell me that I want 1 kg of this item, 1 kg of whatever I'm selling there. I will say, the mark price is 150 rupees, but I'll give you a 10% discount. So you pay me 135 rupees. You will happily pay 135 rupees because you have saved 10%, right? So you want to buy 1 kg, you pay me 135 rupees according to the description that I have given, meaning that the marking is 150, but I am giving you 10% discount. You will pay me 135 rupees. So what you pay me becomes my income. The selling price, 135 rupees. So this is the selling price, actual selling price. Let's say S dash. However, I know that I am not giving you 1 kg. If I am really giving you 1 kg, my costing is rupees 100. For 1 kg, I have spent 100 rupees. But am I giving you 1 kg? No, I am giving you 20% less. I'm giving you 20% less, which means I'm giving you only 800 grams, 0.8 kgs. I'm not giving you 1 kg, I'm giving 20% less. 20% less of 1 kg is 0.8 kgs. If 1 kg has costed 100 rupees, 0.8 kg will cost how much? 80 rupees. 1 kg the cost is 100. For 0.8 kg the cost will be 80 rupees. This is the selling, this is the costing. So this is the real cost price. In this transaction, the real cost price is 100, but in this transaction, the costing is 80 rupees. So you come to me saying that I want 1 kg of this item. I say, yeah, you have to pay me 135 rupees. You pay me 135 rupees. I give you 1 kg, supposedly 1 kg. But actually what I've given you is only 0.8 kgs. And for 0.8 kg, my costing is 80 rupees, right? What is my kharcha? Mera kharcha kitna hai? 80 rupees. Kyunki maine aapko sirf 800 grams diya hai. Aapne mujhe kitna pay kiya? 135 rupees. Right? And maine aapko ek story bata di hai ki bhai, list price to 150 hai, main aapko 10% discount de raha hun kyunki aap mere regular customer or whatever it is. So now the values that you have to play with is 135 and 80. Selling price is 135. Not the selling price actually. This can be called as income. My income in this transaction is 135. My expenditure in this transaction is 80. You understand? This is like income. I'm using selling price and cost price terminology because it's easier to follow that way. My expenditure of the transaction is 80 rupees. Now, how do you calculate profit? Profit is income minus expenditure by expenditure. So overall profit. Don't write overall profit in the exam on your paper, right? You won't get extra marks for this. You'll only lose 3-4 seconds in writing this. Overall profit is how much? Actually, profit is selling price minus cost price by cost price into 100. But selling price is equivalent to income. Cost price is equivalent to expenditure. So income minus expenditure by expenditure into 100. So 135 minus 80 by 80 into 100. Do the calculation, you'll get the answer. What is 135 minus 80? 55. So final answer is 55 by 80. This is like X is what percent of Y? Remember our data interpretation questions that we have solved a few minutes ago. X is what percent of Y? X by Y into 100. 55 is what percent of 80? 55 is what percent of 80? Do the calculation. How do you do it? How do you do the calculation? How do you do this calculation? Understand. 10% is 8. I've told you, right? Always forget about this 100 and all that. Don't say this is 5 times, this is 4 times and all that. 20 into 5, 20 into 4. All that is not needed. Forget about 100. If really required, we'll involve 100 in the calculation. Otherwise, just forget about it. Only deal with the fraction. 55 by 80. And don't even try to do cancellation here. Like 5 into 11, 5 into 16. You understand? 5 11s are 55. 5 16s are 80. That drama won't help you. Simple understanding is 100% is 80. 100% is 80. So 10% will be 8. Now try to represent 55 in terms of 8. In terms of multiples of 8. See, I know multiply both sides by 7. This has to be done mentally again. What happens? 70% is equivalent to what? 8 into 7, 56. Which means 56 is 70%. 56 is equivalent to 70%. But the actual numerator is not 56. If the numerator was 56, I could have straight marked the answer as 70%. But the numerator is less than 56. The numerator is less than 56. If the numerator is actual numerator is less than 56, answer should be less than 70. Very close to 56, by the way. 55 and 56 are very close to each other. But it's lesser than that. Slightly lesser than that. So slightly less than how much? 70%. Option 1, option 2, option 4, option 5 are eliminated. Option 4 and 5 are anyway out of range. It should be less than 70. These are more than 70. So eliminated. Option 1 is anyway out of range. Option 2 and 3 are close to 70 and less than 70. But 65 can't be the answer. It should be close to 70. Option 3, 68% is the answer. 68% will be the final answer. Approximately. Yeah. Now, those who all feel that the solution has become lengthy, ये बहुत लंबा हो गया है, इसको मैं cut short करता हूँ, right? Let me explain कि how do you, what do you actually put on paper? In my view, all that I'm highlighting in red is not to be put on paper. This is, see, don't go by the length of the explanation, right? I'm explaining it. I'm not solving it. I'm explaining it. So it takes more time. Do you have to write cost price is 100 rupees per kg assumption and all that? No. Do you have to write mark price is cost price plus 50% 100 plus 50% of 100 and 150? No. 100 and 50% more than 100 is 150. Straight. Discount is 10% of mark price. Nobody is going to give you marks for this. Selling price is mark price minus discount 150 minus 15 135. No. All that you see in red here is to be avoided. Which means, I say that when I read the first statement, a seller marks the price 50% above the cost price, I know this is 100, this is 150, this is 15, so selling price is going to be 135. Huh, what you have to do is this. This part of the solution is important, which I'm highlighting in green. You should do this in the exam. कि भाई 1 kg अगर 35 rupees, मतलब इफ द कस्टमर इज पेइंग मी 135, दैट्स माय इनकम, आई एम गिविंग ओनली 0.8 kgs, सो आई एम स्पेंडिंग 80 rupees. एंड आफ्टर दैट डोंट राइट ओवरऑल प्रॉफिट एंड ऑल दैट, जस्ट डू दिस कैलकुलेशन, 55/18 × 100. You should look at the numbers and mark the answer. Don't even put this. 100 is 80, so 10 is 8 into 7 on both sides. All this is paperwork. You have to cut it down, right? So if you look at the screen, it looks to be a clumsy and lengthy process. But in my view, hold on. In my view, what you really need to put on paper is just that green portion. The red portion is to be avoided. This is for the sake of explanation. Immediately, I should know that answer should be less than 70% and very close to 70%. Option 3, 68 is what satisfies those conditions. So don't go by the length of the explanation, right? Don't go by the length of the explanation. Just cut down the number of steps that you put on paper and I'm sure you'll be able to get the answer really quick. Of course, there are shortcut techniques also available. Maybe you can try using effective percentage, etc. But even without the shortcut, I think this is a 30-second problem. 30 seconds also is on a higher side in my